everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we'll be diving into Trello's new feature, Advanced Checklist. Now, this is currently inside of the Business Class Plan, but it does allow you to go a bit more granular with the subtasks inside of any Trello card or board. We'll be checking out the feature today, but before we dive in, a little word from our sponsor. So folks, this month here on Keep Productive, we're sponsored by Woven. Now, for those who don't know, Woven is a powerful and smart calendar application that can assist you in smart scheduling, managing your meetings, and planning your week ahead. They've released some new features that can be really helpful for remote workers and people working from home, including Home View, so you can get important information about each meeting and glance ahead. Zoom integration to make it easy to immediately join a video conference call. Analytics, so you can see and analyze how your team spend time. And iPad support, so you can use Woven across all of your Apple devices. Now, as many of you guys know, I'm a user myself, and my personal favorite feature is the one-time scheduling, which allows me to batch meetings, plan podcasts, and interviews. Now, we're really grateful to have them on as a sponsor, and thanks again to Woven for sponsoring Keep Productive this month. So, folks, as you can see here, I'm on Trello Web Edition, and you can now get access to the free trial for the Business Class Plan. They give you 14 days. So within the Trello Business Class Plan, you get unlimited boards, unlimited power-ups, team board templates, which allow you to create new templates using boards you've already created. Also, Butler automations. Butler was an automated service or power-up inside of Trello that Trello purchased. And also collections to group boards, and this new feature, advanced checklists. Now, there are two ways you can access this inside of Trello. You can access this through the home area, and that's just by going to the top and pressing Trello. You can see that obviously I've got all of my sort of boards area, but you just could go to this area called home. This is basically where you get updates, and as I add more, you'll be able to see that they get added to this your items area, which is essentially all of your checklist items. Now, I'll show you what they first look like, and let's go ahead and create a team board inside of this team area, Keep Productive. So if I go ahead and create the board, you can see that obviously it looks like a regular Trello board. And as you can imagine, you can add in a new area. For example, in this case, I might say to do. And below, what it can do is actually start adding the details to the cards. So now I've got a Trello card here. You can see that it looks regular, like pretty much what you had before, but you got this checklist area and you had the checklist experience before. Now we're going to call this one checklist and add it to the area. And you may see a few differences. Previously, it was just very much a simple checklist like this. You didn't have any of this area down here, which has now been added. So let's start building out a few subtasks to this Trello card to add and show you the features of the advanced checklists. Okie dokie, so as you can see, I've added a few checklist items here, and if I actually tick them off, you'll see the progress appear here. Now, one of the things you'll also see is a little subtask item list here, so that's three subtasks we've added here on the outside of the Trello card. So this new feature they've added allows you to do two things. You can add a due date to this item. So for example, let's say, let's add a few due dates to these subtasks that I've got coming up. And also, that obviously naturally goes in with you adding a general or parent due date to the general task. So if I went and pressed 29th of May, you can see there that that's still appears alongside of these additional broken down due dates. So if you are working in a team, you can naturally invite people, and that's perfect, especially if you're looking to populate the tasks, and something that a lot of Trello users actually wanted to get. Okay, so as you can see, we're all happy with this area. And the great thing is, if you wanted to save a bit of time, let's say you've created a card with a bunch of checklists that you need for later, you can go down here and press Make Template. And as you can see here, this is a template card, and you can create a card from template. So that will save you time, especially if you're building these advanced checklists and want to use them again. Okay, I was a little bit of a wally there and I actually deleted the task, but as you can imagine, you can go ahead and make that template. So the area that you want to go to find those broken down subtasks is actually this home area. So you can go up here and you can see your items. And naturally, you'll have the task in which you can actually tick off, which is very good, especially when you're trying to access it from just this preview. And you can also click into it and it'll take you directly to the task. Now, if you open it up, you can do a few more things like adding some emoji. You can even upload your own emoji. You can also attach other people. For example, if you want to say email Bob in your department, then that will tag them in that. And like before, you can actually go and convert this to a card. And as you can see, all the details are transferred into a brand new Trello card, including the due date, the members, and a bit more detail as well. And naturally, you can see in the activity log that it was converted from the checklist item inside of the existing card, and you can actually go to that one straight away. So the brand new advanced checklist features is only a small tweak to the existing checklist abilities, but it's a big one. It allows you to add more powerful subtasks and also takes your business class experience a little bit further, especially when you're looking to create those cards from templates. It saves you a lot of time. So guys, I will include all the details, release information below so you can check it out. But a big thank you for stopping by in today's video. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you folks all very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.